SEO means search engine optimization, and its sole purpose is to help your pages rank at the top of the search results page. But there are two main types of SEO, the on-page SEO and the off-page SEO. Both are important and they work together to boost your site's visibility on search. So in this video, I will walk you through the key differences of on-page and off-page SEO and point you towards the right direction to optimize your site and pages for higher rankings. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that brings you easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. On-page and off-page SEO are two sides of the same coin. Both are essential for improving your site's search engine rankings, but they focus on different areas. On-page SEO is about optimizing the content, structure, and elements within your website, making it easier for search engines to understand and rank your site. It is everything you control directly on your site, like the text, images, meta tags, and links. Now, off-page SEO, on the other hand, is all about building your site's reputation and authority across the internet. It focuses on activities outside of your website, and we will talk about what they are later in this video. Think of it like running a successful restaurant. On-page SEO is like designing the insides of your restaurant, the menu, the decor, the food quality, and how easy it is for your customers to find what they want. You make sure that everything inside the restaurant is perfect so that your diners have a great experience. Off-page SEO is like the word of mouth and reviews about your restaurant. The more people recommend your restaurant, leave positive reviews, share it on social media, the more new customers will want to come. I hope this analogy is easy for you to understand the difference between the two types of SEO. If it is, how about smashing that thumbs up? So on-page SEO is all about the things you do on your site to help search engines and people understand what your site is about. Let me demonstrate what on-page SEO is in practice. When you decide to write an article, I'm pretty sure the topic is not going to be at random, right? You're not writing a fictional story. Every piece of content is supposed to drive traffic and sales for your business. For example, you think the keyword grain-free dog food for sensitive stomach is a keyword that will drive traffic and sales for your business. But you need proof that people are searching for the keyword. So you will use tools like Ahrefs free keyword generator or WordStream's free keyword tool to discover the search volume of the keyword. And it appears that the keyword has search volume. So it makes sense to write an article and try to rank for this keyword. You won't waste time in writing an article if you know no one is searching for it, right? It's a waste of time and resources. So on a blank page, how would Google and other search engines know what this page is going to be about? The key is optimizing your page with the keyword you are trying to rank for in different places. If you use RankMath, we will guide you on the places to add the keyword. But you first have to head over to the RankMath tab and add the keyword in the focus keyword field. And as you can see here in the basic SEO optimization, it recommends us to add the focus keyword in the SEO title. By default, RankMath uses the page title as the SEO title. So if we add the keyword here on the page title, you would have passed this test. Pro tip, if you add the keyword in the first paragraph of your article, you would have passed most of the on-page SEO checks. For example, we add this intro sentence that contains the keyword, and as you can see, RankMath automatically adds the keyword in your meta description. You will pass this focus keyword at the beginning of your content and the keyword in the content. You will also want to have the focus keyword in your URL. For your info, if you want to edit the URL, SEO title, and description of the page, you can do so by clicking on this Edit Snippet button. And here we go. This is a snippet of how your page will look on the search engines. You can also ask an AI to generate the SEO title and description for you by clicking on the Generate with AI button. And here we go. If you want to use the generated text, simply hover over the text and click Insert, and they will be added to the fields. Now, for the perma link, if you have already added the keyword in the page title, you don't have to worry about this check. Simply click on Save Draft, refresh the page, and the keyword will be added to the URL. Feel free to change it by clicking on the Edit Snippet button. In case this perma link is too long, you can shorten it and include only the keyword you are trying to rank for. Other recommended places to add the focus keyword is in the subheadings and in the image alt text. If you go to RankMath's general settings, right here, And under the Images tab, RankMath has a setting that will automatically add the file name as the image alt text, which is right here, you just have to turn it on. And as you can see, RankMath will use the file name to be added as the alt text for all images. This way, you will never forget about adding the alt text, but remember to save changes. So as we head back to the article, let's add an image block, upload an image. As you can see, I've optimized the file name with the focus keyword, and as I add it to the page, we would pass this check. And in case you do not want RankMath to use your file name as the alt text for certain images, you can go to the image settings and click on generate alt, and a descriptive text will be generated. But in this case, we need the focus keyword as the alt text. Anyway, links are pretty important to on-page SEO as well. So we have a check to add external and internal links to the page. And the tricky part about adding external links is that if you are linking to questionable sites as your source of information, it may do your page more harm than good. So to find credible resources to link to, we recommend using RankMath's Content AI Research feature right here. Simply add your focus keyword, select your audience's location, and hit research. In just a few seconds, you will have many smart suggestions, like the word count range, the number of internal and external links to add to your page, the number of headings you should add, the number of images and videos to add, the keywords to add to your content, your headings, your SEO title, as well as the description, and then the questions to answer in your page, and lastly, the credible links I'm talking about. With this too, you can rest assured that the recommended links are from high quality pages. Most importantly, for your page to rank, the content on your page needs to align with the searcher's expectation. If the searcher wants to learn more about the different grain-free dog food for sensitive stomach, you have to provide them with whatever that they are looking for. A lot of people get confused with content quality. They think that a 2,500 word long article, which is well-researched, engaging, and optimized with relevant keywords, is considered quality content. But quality content really means giving the right knowledge and information the searcher is looking for in the quickest way possible. Anyway, other than these on-page SEO elements, we should also look at the site structure. For beginners, we always recommend building the site with a silo structure. And if you need a detailed guide about that, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Next, we should submit an XML sitemap to Google Search Console, Bing Webmaster Tools, and others. If you use RankMath, as soon as you connect your site with a Google account, a search console will be created, and an XML sitemap will automatically be submitted as well. And if you install and activate a plugin created by RankMath called Instant Indexing, all new and existing articles published on your site will be submitted to search engines like Bing, Yandex, and others. And also, you should make your pages mobile friendly and fast. You can use the Google PageSpeed Insights tool to see if your page is fast loading. A score of 90 and above is ideal. You can also check the page speed directly on your page using RankMath's front-end stats bar. Let's refresh these stats. And as you can see, this page scored 98 for desktop and 67 for mobile. And since most people are visiting this page using a mobile device, we will have to optimize this. If you have troubles fixing your page speed, we highly recommend watching this video right here. There are some easy to follow tips to help you out. The link is in the description as well. Finally, we have to add relevant schema markups to pages because schema markup is the language of search engines. It allows them to understand what the page is about. If you use RankMath, based on default settings, every page or post of your website will have an article schema applied to them. And for RankMath Pro users, you can add multiple schema markups to the page if you need to. Simply click on the schema generator, and here are all the pre-made schema templates you can use on a page. Assuming this is a software review page such as RankMath Review, you can use the software schema and fill in all the information to the best of your ability, and you can use the review rating schema and the pros and cons schema, allowing you to get a review rating snippet on search engines. So I've covered the basics of on-page SEO, but if you want to dive deeper into truly optimizing your site and pages for it, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Off-page SEO is all about the things you do outside of your website to make it more credible and trusted, and as a result, increases its ranking potential. Like what I've said earlier, off-page SEO is like getting other well-recognized people in your niche or industry talking about your website. I'm pretty sure you've heard of some off-page SEO strategies like guest posting, email outreach, broken link building, etc. But not all strategies are suitable for new or beginner sites. Imagine you are a new site owner and you try to reach out to other established bloggers in the same niche or industry. Will high-quality sites be willing to link back to you? No, there is no reason and it is a risk to them. As I've said earlier about on-page SEO, you only want to link to sites that are credible. Of course, you may still get backlinks, but more likely than not, you will only attract backlinks from low-quality sites. So for new sites, you shouldn't be worried about reaching out to others. You should focus more on having a good site structure, which is on-page SEO, getting backlinks by providing testimonials to credible products in your niche, starting your own podcast or YouTube channel or the likes of it, and find internal linking opportunities. And as your site started to gain some traction, then you can start focusing on contributing content and expertise to other websites. Or in other words, guest posting. Reach out to other authoritative sites in your niche with broken links and ask them to link to your resource. Comment on relevant blog posts, but the idea is not to get backlinks, but to start a conversation with the blog owner to open up opportunities. Create link-worthy content, reach out to interview influencers, do reverse image search to reclaim links, appear on popular podcasts or interviews, and many others. And once your site becomes an authority in your niche, you can then coin a new phrase and start a community. These are the things I've talked about in depth in this video right here, the only link building video you need. So if you're interested in finding out how to implement these strategies, feel free to check that out. The link is in the description. So let's recap. The focus for on-page SEO is to optimize elements within your website, such as your content, keywords, headings, links, alt tags, site structure, meta tags, etc. While the focus for off-page SEO is to build reputation and authority outside of your website through backlinks, social media, guest blogging, and many others. For on-page SEO, you have full control over every aspect of your website, but you have less control when it comes to off-page SEO because you can't control the actions of other bloggers or authority figures. The purpose of on-page SEO is to make your website understandable and user-friendly for your audience and search engines. While the purpose of off-page SEO is to boost credibility and drive traffic from outside sources. The speed of results for your on-page SEO is almost immediate because you can quickly make changes to your website elements. And it makes sense that it takes longer to see results for off-page SEO because it relies on external validation. A successful SEO strategy requires a balanced approach that addresses both the on-page and off-page SEO factors. But if your site is new, focus on the on-page SEO first. Establish a strong foundation through careful planning of your site structure and content creation. Once your site is growing in authority, other bloggers are naturally linking to your content, you can gradually start to work on off-page SEO. If you have RankMath Pro installed, we recommend using its rank tracker to track the performance of the keywords you are trying to rank for. Turn on this auto ad focus keyword feature so that it will track all the primary focus keywords of your articles. If you want to learn more about the rank tracker, you can watch this video right here. The link is in the description. Anyway, if you find this video helpful, how about helping us out by smashing that thumbs up if you haven't done so? We are all about helping you grow your search traffic, so if you haven't subscribed to us, do so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.